Dear friends, in this slide I am going to discuss methods for the eradication of weed, fishes, predators, aquatic insects and aquatic weeds. This is actually troubling your pond, culturing pond. So you have to take care and eradicate weed, fishes, predators, aquatic insects and aquatic weeds, aquatic vegetation. Aquatic weeds are unwanted and undesirable vegetation that reproduce and grow in water. If left unchecked, may soak the water body, posing a serious threat to pisciculture. How to control aquatic vegetation? Control of aquatic vegetation can be subdivided into four general categories. Prevention, the prevention is better than cure. Manual and mechanical method, biological method and chemical method. So the various methods to control aquatic vegetation in cultured pond. Manual and mechanical method. Pulling marginal plants by hand, small amount of submerged plants can be pulled out or raked by hand. By pulling a long chain or a cable, a hand pulled cutter consisting of a Y-shaped flat metal piece sharpened on the outer edge, and also weed cutter. By using weed cutter you can manually remove this. Biological method, and in this you have to introduce some herbivorous species like Tinopergian, Idilla, other animals like waterfowl, ducks, geese, swam, etc. This will control aquatic vegetation. And this is belonging to biological method to control aquatic vegetation. Then chemical method, herbicides may be used to control aquatic weeds. By control may vary due to such factors as susceptibility of the aquatic weeds to be herbicide, stage of growth, rate of application and the time of application. Some herbicides may also cause injury to fish if not applied properly. And how to control predators? In this we will discuss predatory fish, how to control the predatory fish. Complete removal can be accomplished by totally draining the water by chemical treatment. Chemical removal of fish population is a widely practiced management procedure applied to pond and lakes used for recreation or for aquaculture. Bats, how to control bats? Bats also creating some problems. Small ponds and raceways can often be covered with nets or wire mesh. Device like flush guns, sirens, horns, bamboo rattles and bells have also been tried with initial success in small nursery pond in Southeast Asia. Farmers sometimes run lines of string on poles set in the pond and attach bright colored pieces of cloth or metal to the string to scare bats. How to control mammals? The best control method involves trapping of the mammals. So legal procedure is available. You have to follow the legal procedure to kill the mammals. Other Non-chemical methods include reducing the food supply, installing protective barriers, and shooting. Chemical control may consist of the use of repellent, fumigants, and baits. Reptiles. There are no pesticides registered for the control of aquatic reptiles. Control can usually be accomplished by trapping or shooting. Amphibians. It can be prevented from entering farms with the proper fencing and by keeping the pond banks and surrounding areas free from dense growth of vegetation. Eradication of predatory and weed fish. Common predatory fish are murrels, catfishes such as Belago, Atto, Claris, Batrachus, Atropinetes fossilis, Ombex species, etc. Weed fish include Puntis, Barbus, Dania, and so on. Pieces of a plant origin is used to control this. Derris root powder, Retinoin is the active ingredient. Dosage is 4 to 20 ppm, milligram per liter. Meghua oil cake, active ingredient is saponin, dosage is 250 ppm. TC cake, 60 ppm. Tamarind seed husk, 50 to 100 ppm. Right, this will be used to eradicate predatory weed fishes. Control of weeds. Weed fish already we discussed. Snails. The application of 12 to 15 kg per hectare of nicotine, that is commercial tobacco dust, or 15 to 18 kg per hectare of saponin on the pond bottom after draining of the pond is reported to be effective in controlling snails in coastal ponds. Manual or mechanical removal of snails can be also be effectively used. When the pond cannot be drained, application of belucide 5 to 2 ppm will be used. These are some of the methods to control snails. Palliquidium worms. Drainage of ponds seldom help to eradicate the worm. Dong 1967 reported that 2 ppm nicotine or 3 ppm belucide are effective. Application of technical BHC at the concentration of 0.08 to 0.3 ppm. Crabs. Jordan 1957 reported that repeatedly fortnightly spraying with a 10% suspension of technical BHC was effective in controlling Sesamo and Sarmatium species. ACN reported that use of the insecticide Sevin. Application of calcium carbide in crab holes, tobacco dust, and several other toxic material and insecticides have also been used to control poisons to kill crabs. Burrowing shrimp. The method adopted for controlling crabs can be used for killing this. Special trigger type traps have also been found to be useful in catching them. Fouling organisms. Regular checking and drying is estimated essential to keep this in a good condition. Regular cleaning and drying is essential to keep this in good condition. Greater use of cement concrete to build water control structure. insects, these are the some of the insect species, right, which also troubling the culture pond. Control of aquatic insects. Aquatic insect and other larvae compete for food with the young growing fish and also cause large scale destruction of hatchlings in nurseries. Application of soap oil emulsion, that is at the rate of 56 kg per hectare with 1/3 its weight of any cheap soap, is a simple and effective method to kill the aquatic air breathing insects. Kerosene 100 to 200 liter or diesel at the rate of 75 liter and liquid soap at the rate of 56 ml, or detergent powder at 2 to 3 kg per hectare water area can be used to control this aquatic insects. So in this slide we have discussed what are the predators and prey and how to eradicate this in culture pond. Thank you very much.